Father, we thank you, we bless your name. You are the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Blessed and honored you are in Jesus' name. Amen. We thank you, God, because you are King and living forever and ever. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are kind. Lord, you are wonderful. My God, you are excellent. Excellent is your name.
Okay, start from 3. 5.
For thou art prevented him, prevented him with blessing of goodness. Thou set a crown of pure gold on his head. He asked life of thee, thou lended him. Even the lenders forever and ever. His glory is great in thy salvation. Honor and majesty have that laid upon him. Praise the Lord. For thou hast made him most blessed. Forever thou hast made him exceedingly glad with thy countenance. Verse 5 says, honor and majesty have you no word laid upon him. I don't know for this point that the Lord will honor. I do know with majesty. There's somebody close to you, Fianos. Honor and majesty have been laid upon thee. Anyone that has been laid with honor and majesty fears nothing. You will not be afraid of anything. Let me tell you one thing. It's better I walk slow and be sure. Hello?
Hi.
Yes, I walk slow and be sure. If you look at the life of Samuel, life of Joseph, it was so slow. Joseph was taken into captivity at the age of 17. At the age of 30, he ascends the throne. And he lived 110 years. He reigned 80 years. Can you remember what I said now? 17 years. Some of us are complaining what they see in life, they never see anything. 17 years are peak of you, are not anything. According to the law of our country, if you commit any crime, you are not going to jail. Because you are not to 18. You were taken into captivity. And it was there from 17 to 30 years. How many years are you spending in captivity?
30 years.
At the age of 30, you was taken on to be a king. And being a king, he reigned 80 years. He lived 110 years before he died. Praise the Lord. 1 Samuel chapter 16. We read verse 13. 1 Samuel 16, verse 13. And Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Israel was looking for a king. Already they made their choice of making Saul their king. But Lord did not choose Saul. And Saul is laid and messed up until the Lord wanted a king after his heart. He called Samuel. I want you to go and pray and choose for me the king that rule after my heart. As he was moving, in the family of Jesse, they had 9 boys. Samuel visited the house. According to tradition, you know, in Igbo tradition, we know when we tell you that you are not going to get married. Please, I don't want walking around here anymore. I said, you know, Hebrew tradition, they will tell you, a first girl, if the first daughter did not marry, second one will not go on, marry. But I thank God for God abolishing that particular evil law. Now, in this one, according to the law, if you really want to crown a king, according to the tradition, you must crown the first son. So, I didn't know who was waiting as someone was about to anoint. He came to the first one and said, "Mother, mm-hmm. This is not it." Second one, third one, 56, sir. And then how someone asked, "Is there no other son that left in the house of Jesse?" And Jesse said, "There's still that small one, very pretty and bloody. That one that I am sent to go and take care of my force." He said, "Go and fetch him." I believe among all his brethren, they ran to go and come. They come, they are looking for you. They say you should come. And a small boy walked into the not found. As he was stepping, Lord is pointing at someone here, it is you. I said, Lord, say it is you.
Yes.
He anointed David. Bible says, immediately when he touched the head of David, David became a superman with extraordinary miracle. The glory of God enraged David, and David became another person, someone else, that has extraordinary power. And I pray that the glory of God coming upon you, you act in the power in Jesus' name. Snakes and war, scorpion. And he said to John, I said, let that believe have given power to become the sons of God. Now, when I am a son of God, I am a carrier of God. I know of us are carriers of God here. That when I am a carrier of God, I carry the glory of God. I want to remind you what is in your spirit that must be activated in order to walk in this season. You know, most of us believe people are successful when you buy a new car, when you get married, when you build a house, when you are promoted. Success is not about the physical thing. There's the people in life, they are not people are not seeing them, but they are making people successful. And that's what we talk about, be blessed and be a blessing. He said, blessed be the Lord of God, who are blessed with all the spiritual blessings in heavenly places, in Christ's word, Jesus. God endowing you with blessing, endowing you with glory, that you may be able to extend the blessings to God. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3. He said, Jesus Christ is the brightness of God. Hebrews chapter 1, we read verse 3. Hebrew 1, we read 3. For being the brightness of his glory, he extends the image of his person, and opposing all things by his word of his power. When he have not, even he have by himself purged our sin, sat at the right hand of the majesty on the express image of God, the brightness of his Father, that is Jesus. Christ is the brightness of his dad. If you really want to see God, you see him through Jesus Christ. And God said, every man was so much blessed with great blessing, because from that day he walks in glory. From today, we are going to walk in glory in Jesus' name. I want to remind you what we are discussing this morning, dwelling in his glory. You know when someone dwells, can a fish live without water? Yes, it cannot. If you bring fish out of water, fish will die. If you make a mistake and bring fish out of water, fish will die. Fish can never live without water. A man can live without a sin. You can still live a prosperous life without sin. And that is why Jesus Christ came to wash away the sin from you and from you. So that we may be able to enjoy the glory that are taken away from Adam and Eve. Jesus Christ came back to return that particular glory. If you look at the glory, when you are walking in glory, you are not honored. You are so much honored. When you walk on glory, you find out people will recognize you. You become relevant in society. There are some people, they know the glory of God is upon their land. Men know this people are worth. They may not have money, but they want something. Praise the Lord. A brother called me yesterday, what I said, but I just want to know how you are doing. He said, I hope you are going to come for the end of the year. Our village is passing. And I'll just laugh and say, yes, brother, I will come. I said, you know our village is not their voice. Especially when you pray for us. How far am I going? Even if I let go, I don't care. I was busy sleeping. But he said that he raised my ear, that is, some people recognize the voice. Praise the Lord. The voice they're recognizing is not your voice, they're recognizing God that is in you. If they are sure people recognize God in you. And they shall do one thing, getting acquainted with God. God will give you the desires of your heart. No one will have the never take time to seek him. Psalm 63 says, you seek God. Instruction is not easily obeyed. Some people give the instruction, they don't look at it. They will take the path they like, they leave the path. They are going to pray for somebody. Partial obedience is here, but total obedience will give you everything. Even the partial obedience is in a sin. He told Peter, go to the sea, cast on the other side, you'll cut a fish. Cut the stomach, you will see the coins. Pay for your own tax, pay for your own tax. How will it be possible you find money in the belly of a fish? But I want to tell someone, after today, so many of us will find money in the belly of a fish.
Amen.
You ask me how this was. I remember I told you a story of it. A young woman that her husband many years ago died. She wanted to go and buy fish. And her little girl, whenever they bring some money, you told her that you can find money in the belly of a fish. Saying yes. But money you bought fishes now, you couldn't see any. The mother said, daughter, one day we'll find out. Faith speak. Faith is now. You can't get any miracle from God without faith. One day the woman went out to go and buy fish. And the woman she bought fish from her hand, she wrapped the fish with newspaper. She came back home and was trying to cut the fish. He saw the notice and advertisement that we are looking for social services and social something. If anyone that I know you, he should let him know that the company is looking for you. Her husband was late. And the woman looked at the newspaper and called the name of her husband. And she ran. Her husband was paid a money of 5 million then. There's still money in the belly of a fish. Newspaper that carried the advertisement of her husband. They are not sold that time. And the woman did not know that the company had been looking for her husband to pay her the due that is supposed. And the woman, they are suffering. But God had a plan. Tell somebody God had a plan for me. I don't know how many Christians are confused. Because at the point you start, you didn't see anybody. But God said, I don't need you, I will never do or forsake you. God is not looking at any man to love you. And when they see the glory of God, they will flourish. You can't flourish without seeing the glory of God. It takes beholding the word of God and revealing the word of God in you to be able to see the glory of God. And when the glory of God is revealed in your life, you will prosper in every area of your life. Even though the country may be going up, going down, he said, when men will talk about back and sit down, I will be talking about what later on. That's what the glory will tell you. Praise the Lord. I needed to move on with the glory. Many children are being intimidated with what the system of life is saying to us. Because they never understand what they have been filled with, what they have been made of. Imagine when you tell somebody, go and hit their leg on this pillar. Sorry for you, you break your leg. Because the iron that is there, the stone that will, if you hit it, you go on in pain. God has fortified that when enemy attack you, they will go home injured. So many of them will enjoy you. The enemy that attack you will be injured. See, most of the time the enemy attack you, they don't do you. I say, you. You don't know the struggle of my pain. You don't know the one in pain. They are the one in one pain. Because when they will come out, you will be complaining. You thought they from speaking up seven times. Can someone shout glory?
Glory!
It is only the mention that God comes when he fall down. One of my brothers came to me. When I was coming up, I asked the brother, can you help me to start small business? He said, how can he go, my brother? How can he give me money when I'm wearing the kind of clothes he's wearing? You know, sometimes when people talk, I look at them. I say, what I'm doing all that time is okay. I'm not a hanger. Okay, God. You saw the Okay, God. The same color, the same thing. Yes, you can buy good material that time, Okay, God. Okay, God. You are angry when I wear Okay, God. When I wear good clothes, what will you do? You cut off my head. People say they don't want to help you because you're restful. You're going to dwell down. You are making case of yourself and your God. If anyone don't want to help you because you wear a wish you, let's go! God covered them because they lost the glory. But Christ then I talk about set of mind. Yes, you talk about your set of mind leading to your glory. What you think about yourself. If you think right about yourself, you experience the glory of God. And I know someone is experiencing the glory of God this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If you were on the point we hope with Jesus Christ, we have to let him to be our own. If you are at home, if you are at home, I talk about sinking. If you are at home with Jesus Christ, we have to let him to be our armor. You have to embrace it over and over and over again, trusting him in faith, casting him and rewards in obedience. If you are at home with him, we have to now do what? Believe him, trust him, over and embracing him, holding on him, over and over again, trusting in faith and in obedience, not disobeying. You know that the God that made promise is faithful and not to bring it to come to do what past. Exodus chapter 40. Exodus chapter 40. I will read from verse 34. Exodus 40.
Somebody's for
Same thing with a young man.
You will suffer it. Time will come when you If you have read the word that my family is doing any work, yes. I do everything with you. Everything you are doing at all, I do painting. I bow head. My Habami head is my home. I don't collect money for that one. Everyone is up today is in men. Boys, they are not my grandma will be crying. You want to bring me out of us in the house? I will bow head. If you want to relax, I will relax your hair. I have one style that I bow that time. And it's only one day. You don't see sport on this day that time. My sandal makes noise in the class. I hope if you move here, chant. Hey, come here, get down. Why are you making? I'm not making noise. They look at it, there's a protector here. I'm not protecting you. We buy the same sandal. I will go to a shoemaker. I will buy another shoe. Remove the gold or put our hand in the studio and we'll come ticker. You go that time, you look at the around, it's not the same thing my own. But at the same time, instead of everything, you will wonder, I will not tell you the secrets. That time is now we have original false blood polish. Not what you have now. Original false blood. If you polish your sandal, you look at the way your sandal looks. If you move on the street, you look at your sandal. If you wear belt, you put it back here, put it in your rest hand. Then your pass is their boots. You want people to see your apples, you want people to see your chemistry, you want them to see your biology, your moving, going around the street. You wear the car, you see the girl was up. You see, they don't wear the thing white shirt. Hello? That's where blue came out. That's where blue. And you must know the kind of blue put on a shirt. Some people use ink to put their blue. Hello? Some people use that. So put their view. But you want original view. And use it. Use it and do what you want to do. You use their mind. How do you know you wear clean white shirt? This is where we know. We are white very clean. Here is brown. You know they wear white blue shirt. Because at the day you use, not here where they wear it to a line. You are happy to tell us whether you are wearing blue white shirt. Without here, they are not putting on white, they are putting on narrow shirt. Praise the Lord. We move on like that, like life.